Hiya. So I've met this guy today at the protest in London. He's apparently a veteran protester. So I'm going to speak to him now about some of his experiences with protesting, experiences with the police. So just wondering if you could tell people what type of behaviour to expect from the police when you're attending these type of situations.
Luckily today, at the end of the police literally just bugged off. Usually, especially in like the drone protests or ones, they usually kind of try to confine you. They call it containment, but yes, you can't get out, they're not allowing you out, they're not allowing you back in. And then when you're refusing to go anywhere, which most people do, they say, this is your protest zone, go over there now. And then you stay in your protest zone, and then they go, this is no longer. You stay there, and then when you're all round the lot, they usually send you to that squad. And in the Dover protest, I think a couple of us got hit.
So were you at the Dover protest?
Yeah, I was.
Tell me a bit about that. What was that about? And what happened and what were the reasons?
Reason was the confusion and it went the first time the neo-Nazis were by themselves, they called cavalry Dover.
Yeah.
And then we went there basically, whenever the neo-Nazis there, we go down to Dover to try and like...
So your party was marching against the people who were marching for Nazis?
Yeah, and also to make sure that the food for the refugees get to Calais as well.
That's good, that's really good. So was there some sort of trouble there at this event then?
Not with the Nazis, because they contained us, but the police, they kettled us in, but they didn't really care about the Nazis.
These Nazis often seem to back down from the police, don't they? They don't seem to have much steam when the police come over. The Nazis always seem to back down from the police. I've seen that at other protests before.
Yeah, at the Nazi protest, we got a call from a couple of guys saying, because of the containment that we were refusing to go, two groups of five started fighting each other in the park because they got too drunk.
Right.
And when they came down, they weren't too happy enough, they weren't smiling, they were just the fast friends were all laughing.
Wow. So what was the police presence like at Dover then? Was it the same as how it's been today?
Today it was a little less. Dover, they kind of like catch me out.
They
checked
the Nazis.
All the way out.
So what drives you to be an activist? What's your cause? What's your reason?
Freedom of speech, freedom of protest, racism. Loads of things are like, I don't really want the government to control me because I want to do what I want to do. I don't believe in laws, I believe in morality. If something's moral, I'll do it. If it's immoral, I won't. I don't, even if it's legal, it's legal, that doesn't matter to me.
I find that interesting. I'm a bit of an activist myself. I'm quite similar to what the things you stand for, but I stand under the common law, but I respect the common law, but I don't like legislation. So, but you seem to have took that activism further. Is that so? You don't recognise the common law?
I don't. Protests. I tend to stick to the laws to a degree. If someone gets hit, I will hit back.
Yeah.
But if someone hits me, I'll hit back, of course.
Right.
But then if police are trying
that's
to
good,
get us, I'll shout out, so try to stop it, etc.
Is it that you're saying that you don't? Am I right in saying that you believe that you don't need laws to tell you right from wrong because you naturally know right from wrong?
Currently, the laws they're meant to be based on morality. Currently, the laws are not based on morality. They've gone past that. They've gone way past morality. They add laws of morality and immorality. So things that are legal still immoral. Things that are legal and also immoral.
I can agree with you that totally. The justice system at the minute is out of control in my eyes. And how do you feel about protesting and what it can achieve? And
well, protesting is more to get out there, make everyone aware of it, the people are actually fighting for. Because many people don't go to protest because of the police, because they're scared to get arrested, they're scared that something will happen, they're scared that something will happen to the family or whatever. Most people don't go to protest because they don't want to be shot because other people in their family and friends believe in what they're protesting against, or because they just don't want to face out there if they're having a force to stop it.
So have you travelled far today? Are you a Londoner?
I'm local.
That's good.
London.
So do you attend a lot of these protests then?
Definitely.
That's good. Do you intend to do it in the future?
When I get my next month I can't go to any, but then after that I'll be protesting.
And do you think that the number numbers for these protests are increasing, decreasing?
I would say they're definitely increasing because last time, like definitely in the first stone, they only had about 200 people. The second one, they had about 350 people, and only about 70 masks. So it's definitely increasing. And people are becoming more aware that people are standing up to dance against legislation and laws that are wrong.
How do your friends and family feel about your activism? Do they agree with it? Has it caused you any problems?
My friends...
I've had problems myself, and I sometimes feel alienated, but I still feel the need to help the people who are alienating me.
Well, my friends don't really... Like, I don't really have many friends because of what I do, and also because of my character and stuff. My family don't like what I'm doing, but I still do. I say because I'm 16, because I'm a young girl, I take care of myself. So even if they say no, I still walk out the door, because usually I can do it, I still go out. But my brother is on the assumption that the law is good for me, and I just don't believe in that.
It's good to see passion in someone so young, and I hope that you carry on your activism, because you seem a very level-headed guy, and you seem the type of guy who's going to convince and show other people that there's some sort of reason and you know, to support activism, people need to come together really, and I feel things like this where youngsters like yourself, it's a good way to connect with the youth, because there seems to be a lot of separation within society, and yeah, I feel it could only be a good thing. I wish you the best of luck. It's a great interview anyway. Ciao, lad.